Memphis Depay. Memphis Depay.
Oh my God.
Mourinho, who keeps calling you, bro?
Relax, it's not a big deal.
Are you sure about that?
Hello?
Now, I believe I bought this one-to-watch card all the way back before he transferred to Lyon. 72,000 coins I spent for him. Don't exactly know how much he's going for right now. As a matter of fact, let's check. List on the transfer market. His max is 610. He is going for 200,000 coins now, so made a bit of profit. But there's no chance in hell that I'm going to be selling this card because he looks like, honestly, one of the craziest cards we could possibly be using this year. Before we get the episode, boys, I just wanted to apologize for not uploading yesterday. My girlfriend's grandma was in town from Toulouse. She lives in France. She was here for about a month and a half and wanted to take us out to dinner and lunch and have like a whole family day. So I was not able to get home and record a video, so I feel really, really bad about it. The second time in a matter, I think, of 2.5 or 3 months where I didn't upload daily. And honestly, I thought about it in bed last night. I was like, man, I let this Wakeorium down. I let the boys down. I didn't upload. I felt really bad, but I really couldn't do anything, and I suppose if there's a reason for not uploading once, family's probably the best, probably not, I don't want to say excuse, but the best reason not to upload, because I was doing family stuff, so hopefully you guys can understand. Also, on an emotional note, Podolski's retiring on Wednesday, so for the entire week, we're going to have the German national kit lined up in the background.
And we're also going to be wearing our little pony cap.
Without any further ado, let's dive right into an 86 inform. Had himself an 83 overall inform for Manchester United and has 2 informs already for Lyon. Has just been absolutely tearing it up for them. Again, the only thing that is a little bit weak about his card is the fact that he has 2-star weak foot, 4-star skill moves. He has 99 shot power, 89 strength, 92 long shots, 97 curve, 96 acceleration, compared to 84 Martial, who's the card that everyone compares him to. Obviously, Martial's highest rated card is an 84 in form, who is one of the beasts for me in Weekend League and Ultimate Team in general. Compared to 84 Martial, Depay has +5 strength over that card, +4 stamina, 84 vision to Martial's 78, and the Martial has 74 long shots. Even though he can pop some from distance, finesse's outside the box and such, 74 long shots versus Depay's 92 is actually pretty crazy. Also, a lot more strength, and like I said, a lot more stamina as well. We've thrown Depay into this full inform league inside. We've got 85 Tolisso, who goes for 200,000 coins, the cheapest on the market. Club 80. Completely flew under the radar. Had no idea this guy was in Club 80. We've got Tavon, or Tavin, I'm not sure how you say it. If you're French, maybe you help me out and let me know. 4-star skill moves, 85 pace, 85 shooting, ridiculous distance shooting capabilities. And then we could have gone with a plethora of different strikers. We could have gone with Balotelli. We could have gone with SBC Lacazette, but we wanted to go with Braithwaite. One of the Danish Vikings. We absolutely love his card. Used him very heavily early in the year. And then, of course, we ended off with Memphis Depay. But that is going to be the episode, boys. We're going to get into some foot champs matches, some qualification matches. If you guys do enjoy the episode, hit that like button. Let's try and blast 86 likes for Depay's one to watch highest rated inform card. As well, if you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. Looks to be one of the better Dutch players in the game, better wingers period in the game. Let's get into episode number, let's get to match number one. Los kits. On this episode, I introduce to you the blood and scheiß kit, which translates into the blood and shit kit. We're thinking about doing something like 30 days of kits where every episode, yeah, we try out a different kit. Maybe if you guys have some kits that you would like to see featured in Epi, you guys let me know in the comments below. Was maybe gonna use the Wexford youth kit today, but we've shown that enough. I want to try kits out that no one has seen. Like, I don't think anyone has seen that St. Pauli. Bundesliga 2 team St. Pauli, not a lot of people probably know what their kit looks like, but that is a pretty hilarious looking kit. Al Jaid at night, come on. And I know what you guys are probably thinking right now, Zway, why are you running the 4-3-3? You're shit at the 4-3-3, bro. Dude, we're going to try new formations until we actually get it. Okay, here we go. Tolisso! Wow! Making the great little run, and then an animation that I haven't seen a whole lot this year, where the ball's so close to the keeper, Tolisso just, like, tips it right past him. Dude, beautiful animation. Yeah. haven't seen a whole lot of Depay. Tolisso's been incredible. Braithwaite's made some good runs. Dalvin has been faster than advertised with that 85 pace. Feeling pretty good about our momentum going in the second half. Let's take off. Let's see if we can get Depay a couple goals.
Memphis coming inside as he loves to do. Memphis. Great first time.
Whoa! Depay! The 97 curve! Diarrhea elbow and diarrhea kit. Dude, the ball should have gone off. What a beautiful, beautiful little run. That was all Memphis Depay. He created that entire goal-scoring opportunity. Oh, dude, I scored so many goals this weekend, League, with that particular move.
Earlier on in it as well, it's a splendid effort. But United have had just a bit too much for them tonight, particularly second half. Memphis
is that's another goal! Let's go!
That's
dude! Depay's finesses are insane! And I have him on an instruction to cut inside, which I'm not sure is... And then rage quit. Well, that's the easiest rage quit we ever got. 3-0 victory in match number one. 12 shots, 6 on target. That last Depay one, I wanted to see the replay. Hold on a second. Wait, what? Match number two, and we are coming up against his FIFA card rival, Martial. He's got himself his own 86 rated Dalvin. He's got 9 goal in Pogba. Was Depay a one-hit wonder? Or can he do that every game? Oh, come on, dude. 3 goals, 2 matches, 1 to watch, 86 to Depay.
Great save.
Great save, Lopez. Wait, Braithwaite with that pass, though. Dude, look at Pereira, bro. Getting back on that dude. The unheralded defensive play.
I'm getting the other one right here. Breakaway time.
It's the Braithy! Dude, he was coming in for a Danish log kick. We were unlucky not to get another one there. Pretty close match outside of that run from Depay. 1-0 right now. Very, very delicate lead. Unlucky that we didn't go up. I don't know what else I would have had to do to get Braithwaite to put that away, but just put it slightly too far in front of him. Easy heading opportunity. And unlucky for us not to put it through.
Bro, he's looking for a goal.
Wow! Oh, the man! Let's go! 2-0, 61st minute.
And that's it. That's going to be game. Let's give it to Pi. Let's give it to the man of the hour. What is Chip? RB?
Second half. Memphis deserves a goal.
No, Herb is RB. Come on, boys. Match number two is in the books, and we get ourselves the team hat trick, but not to the Depay one. Man of the match for the second consecutive game, 9.2, and we're not forcing it to him. He's just naturally getting in these positions. And if Depay's not there, it's Dalvin. Braithwaite is acting more like an attacking midfielder, strangely enough, in this formation. Sort of like a false nine type thing going on. But really liking the way the formation's playing. Let's get in the third and final match. Let's see if we can get ourselves a third consecutive victory. Match number three, and he's playing Dembele at striker. The Demb at striker? Woo! Come on! Dude, I've scored like every goal from that position! What is it about my finesses today? I mean, like, I outplayed him possession-wise 63%. This guy gives the ball away quite a bit, but the chances he has had, he has just been so unlucky. Lopez with a couple amazing foot saves. The crossbar came up with one. He just missed one wide once. Taliso, bro.
I'm the one they all fear. I was the man of the year last year.
Taliso, how did you miss that? You've given this one away, bro. Oh my god, we just gave that away! That was the momentum changer right there. The Taliso miss, we were playing incredible. The build-up play was amazing for most of the match. We got lucky with some Lopez saves. He had a couple misses. But that Taliso goal, had we put that away, it would have been 2-1. It would have been 2-0. Would have been the game-breaker, would have put us well ahead. And then he literally just goes right down the pitch and scores with his guy. Now when I say Depay is worth the $250,000 for his one to watch card, it depends. I mean, I don't think that's incredibly expensive for a player of his caliber that you get. You get a really good league with a lot of good players. You get insane in stats. And especially if you like using a guy like Depay, who has a lot of strength, could actually even try him as left forward in a narrow formation or just try him out at striker, period. Definitely one of those players that I enjoy using. Might actually use him this weekend as a super sub. But that is going to be the episode, boys. I give him 2 thumbs up. Was absolutely insane for me. If you guys did enjoy the epi, hit that like button. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. Foot Champions Rewards tomorrow. Ultimate World League Episodia number 5 on Wednesday with a cheeky informed surprise that I'm going to be bringing for that Wednesday Episodia. So hopefully you guys are looking forward to that. I will see you guys per usual for another upload tomorrow. Till next time, boys. Tschüss. Later. Adieu.